Hello, and welcome to Potato TikTok, or as some may call it, the Promised Land. Here we love potato, live potato, and laugh potato. The first rule of Potato TikTok is that we all really like potatoes. Guys, I'm going to be quiet so you can hear the crunch of the final of the 25 potato recipes. The 15-hour potato recipe. It is so, so good. First of all, get your Maris Pipers peeled and really thinly sliced into duck fat and salt. Give them a good old toss, get them all mixed together. Then into a tray that's lined with a bit of parchment, lay them on top of each other one by one until they're tall and compressed into the oven, nice low temperature, 120 degrees. That's going to comfy them. When they're done after 3 hours, take them out, put some trays or tins on top into the fridge for 12 hours. You're going to compress it completely so that it's nice and tight. Then get your measuring tape out after the 12 hours. Cut them all up into however you want. Get fancy with it. Get professional. Do the maths. Fry them off at 190 degrees and you get crispy, crunchy 15-hour potatoes.
The best way to roast your potatoes. Use small potatoes and boil until fork tender. Drain off the water and put them in a big bowl. We're gonna start with a generous amount of olive oil. You're gonna do salt, pepper. We're gonna go onion powder, garlic powder, crushed red pepper, fresh basil, fresh thyme. Get that all mixed together and dump it out on a lined baking sheet. Spread them out, give them a little room on every side, and then use a glass to smash them about a half inch thick. And then throw them in a 425 degree oven for about 30 minutes. But you're going to want to flip them halfway through. And you're going to end up with a soft interior, crispy exterior, the best roasted potatoes you've ever had.
If you love potatoes as much as me, you have to try my crispy spice potatoes. They are packed full of flavor and so easy to make. While your potatoes are boiling, it's time to make your marinade. Mix all the spices, grate some garlic, and drown it in olive oil. Let your potatoes go for a bath in that gorgeous sauce. Now for the magic. Smash them down and brush on all that extra flavor. Pop in the oven till they're nice and golden and you hear that sizzle. And here's my favorite part.
I think if you made this dish for someone, they'd probably fall in love with you. What's not to like when the two main ingredients are potatoes and butter? So let's make it. Start out by preheating your oven to 450 degrees Fahrenheit. Then you're gonna get some russet potatoes and make sure to peel them. I used about 5 medium-sized ones. Cut them thin just like this. Now for the best part, we whip up our garlic parmesan butter. Unsalted butter, parmesan, salt, black pepper, Italian seasoning, and dried parsley. Now grab your skillet and it's time to layer. It goes butter potatoes, until it's full. You get the point. In the oven it goes for about an hour until it's looking just like this. Now it's time to flip and make sure you take a knife around the edges so that it doesn't stick when you flip it over. And our last step is to enjoy.
Mashed potatoes should not have lumps. These are the best. Another episode, back to basics.
3 pounds russet potatoes, or you can use Yukon Golds.
Wash them, don't be dirty.
1 inch dice.
Fill cold water
to the cook evenly.
Bring to a bubble over high heat.
Poach your salt vigorously.
Bubble 10 to 12 minutes. Return to the pot. The heat of the pot will evaporate the excess moisture.
Don't skip this step. If you do, they'll be watery. Let it set 5 minutes. 3/4 cup unsalted butter.
1/2 cup heavy cream.
Melt the butter and warm the cream medium low heat.
Use a ricer or a food mill. No lumps.
Add the butter and the cream.
Truffle salt, because you're fancy.
Truffle oil, because you're extra fancy.
Day 6 of 25 potato recipes. We've got fondant de pomme de terre, or as I would call it, a potato fondant. Now, you want to peel your potatoes, get them cut down to the same length and a similar width if you can. Just trim them up as however you need to. Then get some butter into the microwave and then set it in the fridge. This is a quick way to clarify the butter. Poke a hole in it and get all that milky bit out and you've got clarified butter. Get some butter onto the heat, get your potatoes in there, bring it up nice and hot so they get a bit of colour on one side. Once they've got a bit of colour, add some stock into it, flip them over. Then you want to reduce that down by about half. Add a cartouche on there as well. Once it's reduced down, you want to then keep it going until you're left with just the buttery bit and all that liquid from the stock has gone. You want your potatoes to stick to the bottom because that's what's going to give you the golden crispy bit. Once they can wiggle free, be very patient with them. Don't try and pull them out, otherwise you will lose that crispy bit. Wiggle them out and eat them and enjoy your fondant.
That's how everybody should be making their potatoes.
Let's clean our potatoes.
After cleaning my potatoes, I cut them an 8-inch thick with a mandolin. You can use a knife if you like. Melt half a cup of butter, add it to our bowl. Next, we're gonna chop up a 1/4 cup of oregano, 2 tablespoons of thyme, and grate in 2 cloves of garlic. And then next, we're gonna add 1/2 cup of Parmesan and cheddar cheese, and sprinkle in some salt, pepper, mix till they're all coated. We're gonna stack these into a muffin tin, put them in the oven at 400 degrees, cover with foil. And after 30 minutes is up, take off the foil, put them back in till they're nice and brown. Take them out and top them with some Parmesan. Look at that.
Day 2 of potato recipes is my ultimate favourite, Pom Anna. It's delicious, crispy and crunchy. I love it. First of all, get your potatoes peeled, sliced nice and thinly, into water just whilst you get your pan ready on a medium heat, butter, oil. When it starts melting, then start layering up your potatoes. Now you're going to do a layer of potato, butter, salt, pepper, layer of potatoes, butter, salt, pepper, layer of potatoes, butter, salt, pepper. Then you're going to put a bit of parchment paper on there. It's a medium high heat. When it's starting to get golden, like you see around the edge, put it into the oven just for 5 minutes or so, just to make sure everything's cooked. Then flip it over, and this is honestly one of the best, most delicious ways to eat potatoes. You'll thank me later.
I'm going to show you guys how to make these Hokkaido potato mochi with cheese. Start off by boiling 3 potatoes until they are nice and tender. Now mash the potatoes until there are no lumps. For starch, you can use tapioca starch, potato starch, or glutinous rice flour. Use 4 tablespoons of that, and then add about 3 tablespoons of milk, or until the mixture is kind of dough-like. For cheese, I am using fresh mozzarella cheese. I feel like this is the cheese that works best. Roll out 5 balls from your potato dough and flatten this out, and then add your cheese in the center and fold it like so, kind of like a dumpling. Now you can fry these in oil or butter. I chose a mixture of oil and butter. You're gonna fry this for about, I would say, 3 to 5 minutes per side on medium to low heat until they are nice and crispy on the outside and very tender and gooey on the inside. Eat these right away because they don't store in the fridge very well. I love potatoes and I love cheese and I love mochi, so when you put all 3 of these together, this just creates the perfect snack.
Oh, oui, I love pomme de boulanger, or from where I come from in Birmingham, it would just be called a potato boulanger. So it's basically a dough from wild potatoes, but it's with stock instead. So first of all, you're going to peel and slice your potatoes, then slice up some onions. You're going to throw them into a pan with some butter to get a nice bit of colour on them. Then you want to transfer them into some kind of vessel, whatever you fancy cooking it in, oven dish. Layer it up ever so slightly, maybe, and then pour over your chicken or vegetable stock. Now the stock is going to get it all sticky and crispy and beautifully coloured. I mean, look at the colour of these potatoes. Guys, overnight, I literally got over 500,000 new followers who are all gagging for patatties. So here's some delicious potatoes to whet your appetite. First of all, it's basically like just posh mashed potato that gets piped and baked, but we're going to make it cool and fancy and I love it. So you're going to make some mashed potato, add a little bit of butter, cream, parmesan, a little bit of nutmeg and egg. Mix that all together and get it to a piping bag with a star nozzle. Now, I don't have a star nozzle, so I'm using a whippy cream canister nozzle and making my own because I'm now called Poppy Crafts. Then you pipe them onto a tray, get some egg wash on them, into the oven at 190 degrees, and they're your perfect Duchess potatoes.
Welcome back to Potato TikTok. You're safe here. We've made twice baked potatoes, crispy roast potatoes, and today we're frying up latkes just in time for Hanukkah. We're gonna grate 3 large russet potatoes. You can use a box grater or a food processor, and I don't peel them because I like the crispy skin. Get some ice water with some vinegar or lemon juice and add in your shreds as you grate them. This keeps them from oxidizing and turning brown. Squeeze out all the liquid through a clean dish towel. Add in thinly sliced shallots or onion and 5 tablespoons of cornstarch, 3 eggs, and mix it really well with your hands. Then add 1/2 cup of matzo meal. You could also use crushed up crackers. By the way, the full written recipe is on my website. Seasoning the mix last with salt, pepper, and garlic powder. Then we're gonna fry them in hot oil. I'm using a 1/3 cup scoop for the perfect size. I learned that from Jake Cohen, and then you wanna smash them down with a spatula. When they're brown and crispy, take them out and put them on a paper towel lined sheet. Serve them with applesauce, and don't trust anyone who eats them with sour cream.